The following is a lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on January 23, 1977, in Bhubaneswari, India.
Varnashrama Dharma. Four varnas and four ashramas. Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Shudra. The Vedic culture means to execute the varnashram. Now we are known as Hindus. So Vedic culture means this varnashram. The Mohammedans from the other side of river Sindhu, they are called as Hindu. Actually, this word Hindu is not find any Vedic scripture. So to accept this position, brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha and sannyas is compulsory. It is not that one has to take sannyas as a fashion. No. Actually, it is absolutely necessary for any person at the last stage of life to accept sannyas. This Ramananda Rai also retired from the government service. He met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised him that now you retire from your governorship and come to Jagannath Puri, your home, and let us talk together about spiritual life. So in this way he retired. So all the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sirup Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Srijir Gopal Bhatta Dasa Raghunath, six Goswamis, the direct disciples of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they were all in renounced order life. About Goswamis, Srinivas Acharya, he has written, Tatta Turnamasesha Mandala Patisane Sada Tuchava Bhutva Dina Ganesha Kau Karunaya Kopina Kanthasito. Please take out.
Kilak Nija Bharko.
Tatta Turnam Asesha Mandala Patisane. They were ministers. Naturally, their associates were very, very big jamindars and rich men. Asesha Mandalapati. Mandalapati means leaders, social, political. So, give up their company. Why? Takta turnam asesha mandalapati saneng sadatuchava bhutva dinaganeshako karunaya kopina kanthasiko. Dina Ganeshako, the poor, mass of people, we are thinking that we are advancing, but actually we are becoming poverty-stricken. But this very word is used, Dina Ganeshako Karunaya. So this time is always, unless the social leaders, the leaders of the society, they take care of the mass of people to educate them. Dina Ganesha Ku Karunaya. If they do not become compassionate to the poor mass of people, who will deliver them? They are poor because they have no spiritual conception of life. So that situation is always existing. Therefore, it is the duty of the leaders of the society, especially of the brahmanas and kshatriyas, to take sannyas and preach Krishna consciousness to the mass of people. Dina Ganeshako Karunaya Kaupina Kanthasito. Now, we have got experience that many big leaders in political field, we have seen this non-cooperation movement. They also took sannyas practically, but they could not live long because they could not tolerate the position of renouncement. And about the Goswamis, it is said, Tattva Thirunamase Samandalapati Saneng Sadatuchava Bhutva Dina Ganesha Kau Karunaya Kau Pina Kanthasito Gopi Bhava Rasam Mitardhi Lahari Kallola Magno Moho Bande Rupa Sanatana Vradivido. There must be engagement, proper engagement. If the engagement is not Krishna consciousness, then this so-called sannyas will be failure. In Calcutta, there was a big barrister, C.R. Das. He renounced everything, but he could not live long, very shortly died with that position. But sannyas means to renounce for the supreme sannyas, not that. If one takes to Krishna consciousness, and if he renounces family life and preaches Krishna consciousness, then he will be happy, and the persons among whom he will preach, they will be happy. I have seen practically many, many big sannyasis. They give up this world, Brahma Sattva Jagan Mithya. This world is mithya, let me take sannyas. But unfortunately, they could not stand in that position. After a few years, they come down again in social work, in political work. That means they could not understand what is Brahma. That is stated, confirmed in this Shastra. Jannera bindakha vimukta manina tai astabhavat avusuddha buddhaya arhiya kritchena parang padang tataha patanti adha anadita-jusma-dangha. Jannera-vindakha, he Aravindakha. Aravindakha is Krishna. The persons who are thinking that have become liberated, vimukta-manina, they are not mukta. Therefore, arjya-kichena-parang-padam, although they underwent very severe austerities and achieved the position in Nidvishesh Brahma, Arujya Kichena Parampadam. But because they could not understand, my Lord, your lotus feet, the Patanti Adha, they fall down. Just like in the modern age, they are going very high by aeroplane or Sputnik. But because they do not get a shelter either in the moon planet or Mars planet, they again come down. So simply speculative knowledge, philosophical knowledge, will not give us actual shelter in the Nidvishesh, Nirakar, Brahma. Actually true, we can realize in three stages. This is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Vadanti tattvatta vidas tatyam jajnanam adhyam brahmeti paramatmeti agvaneti sarjati. The Brahma anubhuti is simply negation of this material world, Brahma sattva jagan mithya. But Brahma anubhuti is not final. We are part and parcel of Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha. So simply understanding of our eternity, Aham Brahmasmi, is not sufficient. So that is only appreciation of the eternity portion. And then if one further makes progress, he Paramatma. Paramat means Chit. Siddhānsa. And lastly, unless we come to the shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, there is no ānanda. And every one of us, Anandamaya Vyasa. God is also Anandamaya. We being part and parcel of God. We are also seeking after Ananda. So you cannot get permanent Ananda either by Brahma realization or Paramatma realization unless you come to God realization, personality of Godhead. There is no Ananda. Ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavita bhi stavijja eva nijarupa tayakaladi goloka eva nivasati akhilatma bhuta govinda madhipurisam tamam vajan. Govinda, Krishna, he is ananda chinmaya rasa. He is in the ananda chinmaya. His ananda is not jara rasa. It is chinmaya rasa. We should not understand or misunderstand. Krishna's lila is just like ordinary human activity. Srila Jiva Goswami has described this Krishna's ananda that Radha Krishna Pranaya Vititi Alladani Shakti Yasma Ekatmanavapi Kura Deha Bhedo Gato Gato. Sri Chaitanya Prakata Madhuna Tadvayam Chaikamartam. We should understand Krishna, how he is Ananda Chinmaya Vigraha. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Ananda Chinmaya Vigraha, combination of Alladini Shakti, Srimati Radharani and Krishna together. Therefore, the Vaishnava sings, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahe Anna. If you take shelter of the lotus feet of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then there is possibility to understand the Krishna science. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is trying to impregnate or push this movement throughout the world through the mercy of Sri Krishna Chaitanya. And actually it is happening by taking shelter of the lotus feet of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. These Europeans and Americans, although they are supposed to be born in Bletcher Javan family, they are taking Krishna consciousness so seriously. Otherwise, it is very difficult to understand Krishna. Manushyanam sahasresu kaschid jatati siddhaye jatatam abhisiddhanam kaschid vetrimam tattam. Out of many, many millions of persons, one is interested how to become perfect. Manushyanam sahasresu kaschid jatati siddhaye. Siddhi means to understand one's own position. We request everyone to take shelter of the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to understand Krishna. Sri Rupa Goswami, he has given his direction. Namo Mahapadarnaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gaurati Senava. Idea is, Sri Rupa Goswami offering his obeisances to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Namo Mahapadarnaya, the greatest magnificent charity, charitable person, because you are giving Krishna prema. Nobody can understand Krishna, but you are giving Krishna prema. Namo Mahavadarnaya Krishna prema pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya. You are Krishna. You have appeared again as Krishna Chaitanya. Therefore I offer my obeisances. Similarly, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who was the learned scholar Pandit in the assembly of Maharaj Pradabhudha, Sabha Pandit, so he also has written many verses. One of them is that Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yoga Sikha Tameka Purusha Purana Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sarira Dhari Kripam Buddhija Stamaham Prabhadya. This Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the same person, Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti. In order to teach Krishna consciousness, He has now appeared as Krishna Chaitanya. Vairagya Vidya Nirabhakti Yogam Sikkhartaneka Purusa Purana Chasata Purana. Krishna is the Purana. Navajau Vananche, the Brahma Sangita, it is said. Adyaita Achyuta Anadi Ananta Rupam Adyanga Purana Navajau Vananche. He is the oldest person, Adi Purus, but Navajau. So, in every way, you will find that if we want to understand Krishna, then we have to take shelter of this Krishna's renounced order of life in the form of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one of the confidential devotees, was a Oriya, this Ramananda Rai and Sikhi Maiti. So it is a great opportunity for the Oriyas to understand Krishna consciousness and through the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We are discussing this talks between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai. You will kindly hear and take advantage of it and be benefited. Ramananda Rai, while talking with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was feeling little shamefulness because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a great sannyasi and coming from a very respectable Brahmin family. And Ramananda Rai, he belonged to the Karan caste of Orissa, and he was grihastha at the same time in government service. So he was feeling little shamefulness that I am teaching Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So when he was feeling like that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu encouraged him, kiva vipra kiva sudra nasikane non jai krishna tattva vetta sai guru. You become a sannyasi, or you become a grihastha, or you are a brahmin or a sudra. The Krishna consciousness has nothing to do with these material things. If you know actually what is Krishna, then you can become Guru. Another place also Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said that jai bhaje sei boro abhakta hincha Krishna bhajanete nahi jati kuladi vicha. Anyone who is a devotee, he is great. And who is not devotee, he may declare himself as great, but he is the most fallen. In the devotional service, there is no such distinction as jati and kula. So, if we follow, the example is there, in your country, Ramananda Rai, then wherever you are exalted. Narottamdas Thakur, he has also said, he is acharya. Griheva monete thake, hagauranga bole jake, narottama mage tara sanga. It doesn't matter whether he is a grihastha or is a sannyasi. Bonete means vanaprastha sannyasi. Wherever he may be, if he is actually a perfect devotee of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I want his association. Never mind. Griheva monete thake, hagauranga bole dake, narottama mage tara sanga. So, Krishna Bhajan is so magnanimous, so exalted. In any position, you can become the greatest guru, provided you follow the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How one can become perfect? Manmana bhava mad bhakta mad jaji manga namaskru. Four things. Simply think of Krishna. This chanting of Hare Krishna mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So you remain grihastha. Bhai Bhaktivinoda Thakur has said, namasraya kari thakoh apana kaje. in whatever occupation he was, remain there. There is no need of changing. But namasraya kuri. If you remain a grihastha, what is your loss if you chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra? And if there is gain, why don't you take it? Simple thing. And Krishna also said, manavana bhava madhuvata madhyaji manganamaskaru mamevaishasi asamsaya. These four things will get you back to home, back to Godhead. What is that? Simply think of Krishna. But from the very beginning, you want to understand the meaning of Krishna. Krishna is nirakar, he has no hand, he has no leg. Then how you think of it? You have to give up all this nonsense idea. Then wherever you lead, you will be perfect by Krishna consciousness. But also, the special advantage is that people cannot become very much advanced in spiritual life. But for Kali Yuga, there is a special concession. Kalau nāseva 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 gati jannatā Hare nāma Hare nāma Hare nāma yuvati. And Srimad Bhagavatam also, it is confirmed, kītanāreva krishnasya mukta saṅga parangraje. So, you remain grihastha, it is now difficult to give up grihastha life, but don't be merge into this black hole. Don't make black hole tragedy. Be alive, take to Krishna consciousness and you'll be able. So there is no distinction in Krishna bhajan, whether one is a grihastha or a sannyasi. He must take the science, then he will be all right.
Diksha from Guru also attach the name of Lord Krishna's devotion.
There is no devotion unless you go to a guru. Forget it. Adu Gurbhasram. First thing, first business is to accept a bona fide guru. Otherwise there is no devotion. It is simply false imitation.
These four things we
say. This is the injunction of Rupa Goswami in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Adu Gurbhasram. Your first business is to approach bona fide guru and take his asana. Otherwise there is no devotion. That has been the defect in the modern society. They imagine this business will be given up. He must follow sadhu margana gamanam, which is prescribed by the sadhu guru. You have to accept that. You cannot manufacture your own way.
One is so fast, and people who are living in this world and also wishing to attain God or just remember God, the preach or say about the God, also the namaskaram, as Gurudev said, that mentioned in the Gita, that all these are fruitless. The soul which is remembering God, either in the form of Krishna, but he has not met a guru, because to get a real guru is a real occasion. It doesn't happen in the case of everyone. It's one in million get a chance to get a real spiritual guide. There are so many in the name of spiritual guide, and people fall prey because his inner soul hankers and inner soul thinks that this is my guru, and somehow I will accept whatever he says, and I will, the ultimate aim and objective is to love God, or to recite his name, or surrender to him.
This question has been answered by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu while he was teaching Srila Rupa Goswami. Ehi rupe brahmanda bhramite kono bhagavan jeev guru krishna kripa paye bhakti rata bhi. The guru word is there. Guru Krishna, if you are actually hankering after Krishna, the Krishna is within yourself. He will give you a guru. He will give you a guru. Guru Krishna Kripa. But we must be fortunate to get a real guru. If I am unfortunate, I will not get a guru. Otherwise, why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Latami Mali Haiya Sai Bij Kareya Aropan. In this way, you'll find in the Chaitanya Chaitanya. So, even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he accepted Guru, Ishwar Puri. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna himself. As Sarva Bhattacharya said, that Vaigagya Vidya Arija Bhakti Yogam Siddhartham Eta Purusha Purana Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sarira Dhari. He is the Purusha Purana Krishna, but now he has appeared as Krishna Chaitanya. So he also accepted Guru. What to speak about? Krishna also accepted Guru. So how you will get the ultimate goal of life without accepting Guru? Why do you manufacture this idea? There is no need of manufacturing. You have to follow. Mahajana jina gata sapantha. If you manufacture, then you will be cheaper. Don't do this. That has become a fashion, that you manufacture your own way of salvation. That is not possible. Therefore, Chaitanya, Rupa Goswami stresses, Adho Budbhasayam. The first business is that you must find out a bona fide guru, then other things.
As Gurudev said, the aim of a human being is to surrender to Sri Krishna, to the lotus feet of the great Krishna.
Yes.
In India, especially, there are so many temples and gods and goddesses.
That has been described in the Bhagavad Gita. Those who are hitogyana, less intelligent, all these gods and goddesses are for them. Hitogyana. Kamastastha hitogyana jajante annadeva. Those who are after other demigods, they are hitogyana. Hitogyana means they have got little knowledge that is taken away by maya. Maya or hitogyana, these words are there. So this demigod worship is for the less intelligent class of man, not the actual intelligence. Actual intellectual is he. Bahunam janmanavante jnanavan maanga prabhatva. There is actual intelligence. When he surrenders to Krishna, Vasudeva sarmamiti sa mahatmasu virya. So, the demigod worship is recommended for the less intelligent class on that. Otherwise, to surrender to Krishna is the highest stage of perfection. Yes. Renunciation is the beginning of this material world. You cannot take, you cannot surrender to Krishna unless you renounce this. If you have got material necessity, sarva-dharmān parityajya, Krishna says, absolute surrender. And if you want material necessity, then you have got so many dharmas. This dharma, that dharma, social dharma, family dharma, national dharma, community dharma, so on, so on. But Krishna demands sarva dharma an paritajya. So it is not very easy thing. Therefore renunciation and surrender. Surrender means full renunciation, no reservation. And renunciation means you renounce something and keep something. That is the difference.